Hi friends, in this video we will discuss OpenAI user self-service forgotten username. In the previous video I explained user self-service user registration module. So now user is registered, after that suppose user is forgotten the username, so then how to retrieve the username. Okay, let's see how to retrieve the username. I will show you. Okay, yeah. So first of all, how to enable the forgotten username. So now here you can see you have a create an account. Okay, so in the previous video I have enabled the user registration. So when you enable the user registration, we will get the create an account option here. So now we will enable the forgotten username. So first of all, login into the application by using the admin username. Okay, now we are in the top level realm. So click on the top level realm, go to services. Okay, in the previous video already I have added user self service and how to enable the user registration, but here I am going to show you how to enable the forgotten username. Now you can see here we have a forgotten username and forgotten password and user registration. User registration in the previous video I have explained. Now here I am going to show you forgotten username. So currently it is disabled, so you can enable this option. Okay, so now here you have options like a capture, you know, correct? Capture like when you enter the username, so it's like validating that is a human or a robot like that. Okay, so but right now I'm not going to show you the capture related things. So here security questions. Okay, if you want like ask the security questions when user forgot the username, then you can enable the security questions. This is I will show you. So here you can see email username. So you can once that user validated the basic information, then system will send the username to the email. Okay, if you enable this option or show username, so on the screen itself it will show the username. So now first I will show you show username on the screen. Okay, and see, and the token lifetime seconds 300 seconds. Okay, because of so this is the default session default configured seconds. You can change it here. Okay, outgoing email subject, forgotten username. Okay, outgoing email body. So if you want to enable this email username, then this email subject and email body using to send the email to the user. Okay, so in this video right now I am enabled the forgotten username and show username on the screen. So I'm clicking on the save changes. Okay, now see what are the users we have currently. Now I have only demo user. Okay, demo user. If you want, you can create one more user here. You can see Narayana. So I'm creating the username is Narayana and password, and you can give something like narayana@example.com. Click on the create. So you can give the first name something like save Narayana, like something. Okay, so click on the save changes. Okay, now so the user is created. Now click on the logout and we'll try to log in first of all with new username. Sorry, so new username is Narayana and the password is like this. Click on the login button. It's a previous session was there, so we'll try to again login. See, the user is valid, so it's logging in to the user profile page. Okay, now click on the logout. Now I suppose the user Narayana user is forgot the username. So here still it is not coming. We can refresh the screen again. Okay, see here it is came, forgot username. Click on the forgot username and let's see here what are the attributes it is asking. One is the email address, either enter the email address or first name and last name. Okay, so I'm going to enter in the email address. What is the email address I have given? narayana@example.com. okay, I'm click on the submit button. So in the next screen it will show the username. Okay, click on the submit button. See, username found, the name is Narayana. Okay, because we have enabled the show username. Okay, Now go to return to login page. Okay, even you can enter the first name and last name. So first name, last name, I have given like Narayana, Narayana. Okay, you can either same name. You can, after validating this first name and last name, you can, it will show you your username on the screen. Click on the submit. See, okay, if suppose if you give the wrong, what will happen? Let's see. Okay, suppose I'm giving wrong email address. Okay, something. Let's click on the submit. So unable to retrieve your username, unable to find account. Try finding your username or return to login. Okay, now let's see how to send the username to the email address. Okay, now login into the admin console. Okay, go to top level realm, go to services. Inside the service, we have a user self service. Here you have forgotten username. So here you can enable the, first we'll enable the security questions and we'll see, okay. First we'll enable the security questions. We have to click on the save changes. But where is the security questions right now? Go to the general configuration. Here we have a security questions. What is your mother maiden name or something? So if you want, you can add the one more question like this, okay, like a file. Is a EN English, and what is your pet name? What is your first school name? Something, whatever it is. Okay, so click on this save changes. Okay, now so what we have enabled here, security questions we have enabled, correct? Now let's, sorry, I can refresh again the screen, come to here. Forgotten username. So we have enabled the forgotten username and security questions. Okay, but right now the user not registered the security questions, but we can register now. Okay, now click on the logout here. Okay, now try to log in with the username Narayana and the password. We can try to log in again. Okay, now see here, you can see the username, correct? User profiles. Here you have a password, okay? And here we can get it the, okay. So generally we have to get the security questions here, see, but the screen was not refreshed, okay? That's why I'm telling, like whenever you're doing the any configuration in the OpenAI level, so better you have to refresh the screen or you have to use the new private window, okay? If in terms of the, Google Chrome, there is a new incognito window. Okay, so better you have to refresh. Now after refreshing only, we are seeing this security questions. Okay, now you can add the security questions. Okay, I'm giving something first car or something like a desire. Okay, desire like this. Okay, and click on the update. Okay, now click on the logout, and now the user is the username. The guy username is like Narayana. He forgot the username. Okay, suppose now I'm clicking again, forgot username. Okay, now I'm entering the email address. Okay, next what will happen? Let's see. Previously, directly username displayed on the screen. Correct. Now what will happen in the next step? Let's see. Submit. See. Now here it is asking the security question. Answer the security question below to retrieve the your username. What was the model of your first car? Okay, we can give the, suppose if you give the wrong, it will give the error. Okay, again you have to try to, security questions answers do not match. Okay, again you can try to, forgot username, entering the correct email address and going to here correct correct security question. Okay, correct security answer, security question answer. Okay, now click on the submit. See, now we are able to see my username here. Okay, so now we have seen two types of ways to retrieve the username. One is the straightforward, after entering the email address, you can see the username. And second one is that we can enter the security question answers and then you can see the your username. Then third one is we can enable the email, like that username will be sending to the registered email address. Okay. Now login into AIM admin console again. Okay, go to top level, go to services, go to user self service, go to forgotten username. There you can enable the, you can disable the show username, you can enable the email username. Okay. And you can disable the security questions also. Okay. But for more secure purposes, you can enable this one also, both. Okay. In the production environment, you can use like both. Now click on the save changes. Okay. Now we have a doubt. So how the Forgerock will send the email? Okay. So for this, we have to add email service. So this email service, how to add, and already I have explained in the other videos, so you can go through that. But I here also I am explaining. So click on the, go to the services, click on add a service, search your email service. Okay. So first click on the create. Now here you can see. So we don't have any valid SMTP server host name now. So we can get it some one of the fake email, SMTP server for the testing perspective. Okay, that is one of the mail trap. Okay. There is a mailtrap.io, so you can also, you can register here, and you can get the SMTP username and password for you. Okay, so now I have already registered, so I have here username and password. So go to SMTP settings, so credentials here. So this is a host name. You can copy this host name and paste it here. And there is a port 465 also here, so 465 you can use, and username is this random generator username, and you can use it here. And then password, copy this one, paste it here. Okay, so this is not SSL, this is non-SSL, and you can give the parameters, anything like some forgotten username @example.com. So here you have to mention the attribute name is email, because of while sending the email, we have to get the email address of the user, correct? So Forgerock will connect, will get the email address from the OpenDJ. So from which field you have to get it the email address, that attribute name is mail. Okay. So here email subject, email content not required, because of we are already configured in the forgotten username, correct? Click on the save changes. Yeah, now we have an email service here. Okay, user self service we have enabled. Now click on the logout here, and you can try that one. Okay, click on logout, refresh this one. So I'm going to click on the forgotten username. So here we have an email address. I'm giving correct email address here and clicking on the submit button. So entering the, asking the security answer. So I'm giving correct answer here. See, it is trying to sending the username to the address. So an email containing your username has been sent to your account. Then go to our mail trap here. So here you can see forgotten username email. So here you can see your username is Narayana. Okay, so here we are receiving the our username. So we have a three ways to retrieve the username. Okay, so in the production environment, we can use security questions and this last step, what we have used, correct? Like security questions you can ask, and you cannot display the username on the screen. You can send the username to the registered email address. Okay. Yeah, this is the forgotten username. Okay. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and share the comments. And thank you.